Welcome back to the Talos Principle. It's time to go get the star. So I know where it is, I know how to get it, kind of. At least I know how to use the jammer on it from another puzzle room to actually unlock the way, but to really get to it, I also have to unlock the way by doing the puzzle normally. Which is kind of funny, because I actually completely skipped doing the puzzle normally because I just went straight over the wall from another puzzle room. So in other words, I have to do this puzzle kind of normally to actually get to the star. So, I guess I actually have to figure this out. Or do I? Actually, wait a minute. Maybe I don't. The fact that I got the sigil means that this thing is opened, which maybe means I can just skip everything. Almost. I still need to get in there. Yeah, so that's where the sigil was. And I need blue power, huh? Okay, I am just going to cut out everything that I did previously attempting to solve this puzzle, because I just realized that I'm totally overcomplicating it. I was trying all sorts of stuff to get it, but I don't need to do any of that. So I can just skip right to the end, because this is opened, since I already got the sigil at the end here. And then I just have two things to get through. I have this, and then the next one. So this one needs blue power, but I can just use a jammer. And then for the next one, I can just use the connector to weigh it down, and then that's it. Bingo. Okay. Now it's time to look for Easter eggs. Got a couple things to test out. So one is that I went and grabbed the Minecraft sword. And I'm wondering if I can slay the dragons. Yeah, success! Okay, it doesn't work. I don't know, dragon's the end boss of Minecraft. Seemed plausible. That's okay, though. I have another idea. So I was taking a look around this place, which actually took quite a bit of work to open up all these force fields, and I found a way to get out of bounds. And perhaps there's somewhere for me to use my Minecraft sword out there. I don't know if I want to jump over here. I kinda wanna jump over there. Oh god. The boundary's not very forgiving. Please don't reset me, please don't. Ooh, interesting. There is a wall here. I mean, there is still collision. I just can't see it. Some weird LOD stuff going on. I don't think I want to step on that little patch there. I might go flying into the void. I don't think I can go there. In an absence of space. No, it's gonna reset me. In the beginning were the word. In the beginning were the words, and the words made the world. I am the words. The words are everything. Where the words end, the world ends. You cannot go forward in an absence of space. Repeat. In the beginning were the words. And looks like I can actually clip my way back into bounds. I think I have to. I think it's gonna reset me if I keep going. Yeah, I don't have to redo all of this to get the Minecraft sword again. Alright, so that's a no-go. Okay, let me do some more looking around. I've taken a really good look around, and I just can't find anything else. Just the Minecraft sword, and that's it. Other than this little QR code, which is unreadable. Now, I would translate this myself, but I actually already tried to, and I can't. I can't get my decoder to actually recognize it because of the vines covering it. It's just a little bit too obscured. So if anybody out there can somehow reconstruct it, I guess, go for it. The thing is, it's a very small QR code, so whatever message it has is not going to be very long. It's probably just like, haha, I made you waste your time decoding this, is probably what it says. Or maybe it's the secret to the universe. Who knows? Here, I'll even go back and forth so you can see what's revealed underneath. I think I'll leave this up to CSI to reconstruct, though. Yeah, there's enough information there that you could reconstruct it, but it'd be pretty annoying. And I don't have the patience for that. I wonder if you can actually turn down one of the quality settings so that the vines actually disappear. Alright. It's time to move on to number 7, which I believe is the next, I believe it's the last, main puzzle room. One star, four puzzles.
My faith in you was not misplaced. You have learned much and shown great wisdom in these trials. The end of your journey lies close now. Do not falter, do not fear, and do not give in to temptation.
There's no time. Just not enough time. We're trying to build the future out of old video game code and half-finished research projects. We should have had years, maybe decades, with the kind of money they used to put into building bombs. If I stop and think about how crazy this is, I will have a nervous breakdown. So I won't. Yeah, okay. Back to work, Alex.
Arcady Journal 108. Team diminishing by the day. Proud of them, nevertheless. Archive now incomprehensibly huge. Still missing thousands of works. Impossible to truly finish. Work already commenced on a sorting program to help catalog the archive resources in our absence. But like everything else, it has its foibles. Talk to Alexandra. Tell us going well. Maybe the archive's first user will be terrestrial after all. Estimate about a week, maybe 10 days before I'm unable to keep working. A betrayal to leave early? This is interesting. Talked to Alexandra, Talos going well. Maybe the archive's first user will be terrestrial after all. What does that mean? The archive's first user? Obviously he's talking about humans, so maybe a human will be the archive's first user, but what does that mean? What does it mean to be a user of the archive? Does that mean that she did put herself or somebody into the simulation? Apocrypha 9. Now Uriel pointed his sword to the Tree of Life, which grew in the heart of dead Jerusalem. Behold, the tree grows still, though the city is dead. Within all that is mortal, there is the seed of immortality, for it is an immortal that fashioned it from chaos and void. Being a humble man of little wisdom, I asked, "Great Uriel, we are not allowed to eat from the Tree of Life. How may we then be saved?" And Uriel commanded me to stretch out my hand, and he gave me his fiery sword, which burned my hand, and he said, "Only by sacrifice can you free the world from the dominion of sin." With a prayer on my lips, I fell upon Uriel's sword, and it pierced my heart. And truly, on my body, the stigmata of the Lord appeared, dripping blood that was not my blood onto the ground. And the seven heads of the dragon that were crowned in black clouds receded, and light fell upon the earth, and Jerusalem was born again. Thus the angels departed, having delivered their message, and I woke in the fields of our fair land. I'll translate that in a minute. Invention of borders. Excerpt from The Invention of Borders. What today's nationalists and neo-segregationists fail to understand, Quaim said, is that the basis of every human culture is, and always has been, synthesis. No civilization is authentic, monolithic, pure. The exact opposite is true. Look at your average Western nation. Its numbers Arabic, its alphabet Latin, its religion Levantine, its philosophy Greek. Need I continue? And each of these examples can itself be broken down further. The Romans got their alphabet from the Greeks, who created theirs by stealing from the Phoenicians, and so on. Our myths and religions, too, are syncretic, sharing, repeating, and adapting a large variety of elements to suit their needs. Even the language of our creation, the DNA itself, is impure, defined by a history of amalgamation, not only between nations, but even between different human species. Tasks. Discuss this excerpt in the context of Wolfgang Welsch's theory of transculturality. So it looks like that's from a textbook or something. Alright, well, I have some translating to do and I'll be right back. There we go. This stuff at the end of The Invention of Borders, right here, translates into hybridity. And in Apocrypha, this stuff at the end here translates into to form the golden armor of science. Now, this might actually be a continuation of the previous sentence. Normally it isn't. Normally whatever you decode is like some random piece of data that does not belong there, but I think this actually is a continuation. Because if you read it out, thus the angels departed having delivered their message, and I awoke in the fields of our fair land to form the golden armor of science. It does seem to actually continue the sentence. So it actually might just be a continuation. It's interesting to call science golden armor. It's a very strange way of putting it. Alright, let's take a look at this place. What have we got? Secrets? Oh, no secrets. Ooh, secrets? Kind of secrets.
Intelligence is more than just problem solving. Intelligence is questioning the assumptions you're presented with. Intelligence is the ability to question existing thought constructs. If we don't make that part of the simulation, all we'll create is a really effective slave.
Yeah, that makes me think that Elohim and his desire to make me obey, and his desire to make me a faithful servant. I think that might be programmed. I think he might be programmed to be that way. Maybe. As kind of part of the test, you know? To try to dissuade me from thinking, but if I'm truly an intelligent being, then I should question everything, even what Elohim is telling me. And I think he's kind of part of the test. He may have gotten out of control, though. He may not be operating the way that they exactly intended. But I think his basic function of trying to make me not disobey is actually a test. This place should be cold, but I don't feel cold. It's as if I was observing everything from a distance. It's pointless. These seem like some very large puzzle rooms. Let's go tackle one. Prison break. Sounds like fun. And the walls are very high. And the walls, at least, well, some of them are actually spiked, which means I don't think I can stand on top of them. But actually, a lot of them aren't. I think it's just the outside walls. Two fans, huh? So I can launch something over here. And the point of that would be what? Could I crack this open from the inside? So there's a connector in there. To get out, I need blue power. Some twisty things, which means I'd probably need two connectors, it looks like. Which means I need to find some more connectors and probably throw them over. So let's gather my tools to start with. So for now, are these fans irrelevant? Hold on, let me see how far they go up. Ooh, nice. Just looking for any stars or anything like that. Okay, so I could use that to power one, two places. But I would need a box and a connector, and if I do that, then the only thing I have left is one fan with which to hold down buttons and stuff. So I don't think I can use this yet. I think I need more stuff. I do need this open, though, so I need to use the fan for that. And I suppose I should use the other fan for that. Yeah, let's get this box. Now I've got two boxes, which is a dangerous prospect. There's a lot I can do with two boxes. Although everything's very flat, so I don't think I can actually jump up on them. Not without a third one. Okay, so there's a connector in there already, and I was thinking if I get two connectors, I could probably open this from the inside. I could maybe trap myself. If I try to throw this connector in there and then go in with it, I might trap myself. I don't know. But I'm thinking that's the next step. Because I don't think there's any way for me to get this connector out at the moment. Not with one connector. No, there's just no angle. Okay, let's toss it in. See what happens. Oh, wait, I can't toss it in directly. It needs to go on a box. That's right. And, of course, it needs an actual fan. That would help slightly. I wonder if I can catch the box in midair. Ah. Well, if I could, I missed it. And let's see, I'm gonna need the blue power, right? Yeah. Wait. I think I might have just screwed myself. How do I get in there? I need both of these open so the blue power can actually be used inside. And I need to get in there myself. Which means I need three objects. Do I have three objects? I do, but I mean the fan has to be here, so. Crap. Yeah, I mean, I can do that, but then I have no way to launch myself over. Stay on for just 1 second, please. Okay, I think I have to reset. Unless I'm missing an item? Nope. Okay, reset time. So maybe I do need to utilize the fans. It didn't seem like they would do much though without having another connector. I mean, I've only got one freaking connector. It's not much to work with. Let me try this again. And what if I have two? Make any difference? Nah, it doesn't make any difference to the height. Well, this would allow me to get power without having to hold down that switch. But I'd have to utilize a box and a connector, which means I'm using up two items anyway. So it wouldn't really seem to help anything. And if I'm to power this by putting the connector on top of the box, then I need to power the fans to get this up high enough over the fence to be self-powered, right? Because if I just put it on the box directly, like right here, the power can't actually reach over the fence until it's lifted up, and it can't lift up until it has power. So in other words, I need two connectors. I need another connector so I can actually power it from out here and make it self-sustaining and then go over this thing. So I do need two connectors. Yeah, I don't think I can do anything with this yet. No, don't! Oh, wait, it's fine. There's a letter. Okay, it's fine. so I can connect this, obviously. But again, I need two connectors. Yeah, I can't do anything here yet. Oh wait, I think I got it. Do the same thing I did before, except don't send things over in two passes. I jump onto the box, and I hold the connector in my hand. That should work, right? I think. Okay, so I can do this, but I need some way... No. How do I hold that down? If I put that on, I'm gonna come off. No, that's not gonna work. Okay, I actually have no idea. So, I'm gonna think about this one, and I'll be right back. Aha! I just found the solution. You know, this entire puzzle is one big ruse. The developers just want you to think, like, oh, you're supposed to use these fans and this power and all that stuff, and they're just trying to confuse you. I found the real solution. Oh yes. Oh yes. This is how you actually do it. And it's definitely what the developers intended. Perfect. One out of four down. Alright, well, on that good note, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and I'll be back soon.